Happy evening, everyone. This is Adesh Jain from Vidyasagar Women's College, welcoming you to the fourth episode of our Power Talks on Personal Branding 1.0. The session is going to be taken by Mr. P.K. Raghunathan. Mr. Raghu is a management trainer and a coach with over 3 decades of corporate experience in banking, insurance, private aviation, and financial consulting. He has a functional experience in customer service, operations, project management, strategy, and training. He has conducted almost 10,000 plus hours of training. If we count it in man hours, it is humongous number of hours, man hour training. Currently, he conducts training and coaching for growth, development, career progression, and problem solving. He has a PGDBA and a CAIAB, and also attended courses on balance scorecard, masterclass for directors, etc. So without taking much of your time, I would request Mr. Raghu to please join us. Yes, Mr. Raghu, you can unmute yourself. Welcome to the fourth episode of our Prayas placement drive. So please take over. Thank you very much.
Am I visible? Am I audible?
Yes, very much.
Okay, greetings to you all. Vanakkam. Okay, today we are going to talk about personal branding 1.0. Okay, why is it called 1.0? I'm sure you must be wondering. The reason being that this is an introduction to the concept of personal branding. There is a huge amount of research and work going on to understand and how it can be done. So this is just a preliminary program on that. Depending on how we are able to take it from here, if required, we can come up with much later on 2.0. Now, just to understand in terms of how today's structure will be, there will be a few polls. We are looking at content presentation. If you're familiar with the presentation so far, we use the PowerPoint presentation to do that. Please feel comfortable to write your questions on the Q&A space, which is available, and you can use the chat forum to communicate to other participants and also to us. But however, if you have any specific questions, please write on the Q&A space. We will make attempt to definitely answer at the end of the session, but if it's possible, we would like to take some questions at the middle also. Endeavor would be to respond to all the questions possible, and I am looking at completing this total session in about 75 minutes, including the Q&A. That's the target. Suggestion, please have a notepad and a pen. Any thoughts that may come to you, you may want to write it down. Temperature is quite warm. Please make yourself comfortable with a bottle of drinking water. And if needed, please feel comfortable to have a cup of tea or a coffee or a juice with you, because you're sitting at home and listening to this, watching this. Please make yourself comfortable. What has been covered so far?
Hello. Dear participant, just bear with me. I think there is some technical lag. We will just connect with you shortly. Just give us 1 second. Yes. Now, you'll have to unmute yourself, please. Yeah.
Yes, I'm really sorry. The power went off and I had to use my mobile hotspot to come back.
Okay.
My sincere apologies on that. Okay, now let's continue on our presentation. Okay, so we were here. Okay, what we have covered so far, we have looked at time and what I do with it. We looked at goal setting. We looked at motivation, self-trust through strokes. And this is the fourth session that we are looking at. Now, this particular session is viewed by faculty members, professors, or who are joining the session. So this program, all the programs have been viewed from the perspective of both of them. So please, I will make attempts to use examples related to both of you. In case there is still a question, please feel free to write your questions at the question answer space. Now we have a few polls. It's okay, open it. So can we have the first poll, please? So there is a poll. You have to pick one of the answers. Now, personal branding is about, is it style or is it substance or is it none of it or is it both of it? So let's look at what is the responses coming in. Okay, nobody is choosing neither. Another about 20 odd seconds to go. Good, about 50 of them have not chosen yet. Would you be kind enough to pick one, please? Adeshji, can we continue
can we extend for another 10 seconds or so?
Yeah, 10, 15 seconds. Yes, please. Yeah. People are just... Whatever is your understanding, nobody knows your answer. It's only you know your answer. Please feel free.
Just another 5 more seconds, we'll end the poll.
Yeah, yes, please, yes, please. Yeah, well, let's stop it. Okay, great. Okay, 73 people have voted, of which 22 said style, 11 of them say substance, 6 of them say neither, and 34 or 47% say both. Okay, that's interesting. Yeah, we can close that. See, these polls that are coming in, there will be 3 more polls that will come in. Please look at these polls that are being asked to share your views and also to get sort of a ringside view of how people are looking at these statements. So you will get a perspective of it. I'm seeing few participants raising their hands. If you have any questions, request you to write it in the Q&A space because we will not be able to address questions. Now we'll take it during, maybe in about 15, 20 minutes, we'll take it. Okay, so that's the first poll. So can we go on to the next poll, please? Now next poll is about, why is my laptop? Yes. Next poll says, if I want news, okay, I want some news. I'm sitting here, I want some news. What would I choose? Would I choose a newspaper? Would I choose Facebook? Would I go switch on the television and get some news? Or would I choose Twitter? So which one would you pick and choose for news?
Again, the participants can choose multiple answers.
Yes, please feel free to choose more responses if you think that you may pick two choices or three choices or all the choices, as long as you're doing it, we want your genuine responses. That's what it would give us, your perspective. Great. I think more people are responding to this question. Excellent. Excellent. Yeah, maybe we can give them another 5 seconds more. Yeah, could we stop it, Mr. Radish? Okay, so we have 39 on 85 saying that newspaper. I'm just jotting it down for my reference. 14 on 86. Choose Facebook. Now 72%. 72 on 86, which is a whopping 84%, choose news channel. Okay, some people are also choosing. Now think for a minute, why would you choose 1, 2, 3, whatever? Why? Think about it for a moment. If I want news, why would I choose newspaper? Why would I choose Facebook? Or why would I choose a television channel? 10 of you have said Twitter. That's very interesting. So what makes you choose Twitter? Think about it, and you can share it in the group. I will view it much later. I will not be able to see it now. I will read it after the event is over. I will read your responses. So you can share it with others. The 10 of you actually have chosen Twitter. That's very interesting. 14 of you have chosen Facebook. What makes you choose that? So maybe you can share your views while you are listening this, or the others can also understand the perspective with which you have chosen this. Also, a question comes to you in terms of thinking about it. Now, many of you have chosen TV news channel. 84% have chosen TV news channel. So also ask yourselves, I mean, which channel are you preferring? Is there a specific channel that you prefer? Or is it any TV news channel that you would prefer? Would you prefer an English news channel, or would you prefer a regional language news channel if you want to know about it? So which one are you picking? And if you pick English, which among them are you picking? And are you picking in Times Now or India Today TV or Republic TV or an NDTV? Which one are you picking? Or if you pick a Hindi channel, which one are you picking? If you pick a Tamil, are you picking a which one are you picking? And are you picking Sun News, Polymer News, Tandi TV? Which one are you picking about it? Just reflect on that. Just ponder for a moment, so that you will find answers when I share the content later on. You will be able to relate with that, why some of it is being chosen by people. Should I change my taste? Should I change my perspective? Or should I just retain what I am doing? Should I continue to look at only newspaper? Or should I explore news from some other forum also? Incidentally, I look at news. The 10 of you have chosen Twitter. I would be with you. I choose Twitter, one of them, as a news channel. Definitely, I pick the newspaper. I also pick the TV news channel. Facebook, I have not used. So let me be candid on that. But Twitter, I definitely use. Can we close that? Close this, please, Adesh ji. Adesh ji?
I've closed.
Okay, great. Oh, it was coming on my screen, so I had to close that. Okay, thank you. Now, third one, there are two more polls coming in. So third poll is that. Now, we've looked at first poll, which one is important for personal branding. Second one, we looked at, if I want news, which one would I choose? The third one is to look at, I want to make myself visible. I'm a professor. I'm a professor of chemistry. I'm a lecturer of physics. I'm a professor of commerce. I'm a principal of this particular college. Now, which one, I'm a student of art, I'm a student of science. So which one would I pick to make myself visible? Well, I want people to know that I exist. So which forum would I make myself? Yeah, I can go out and move around and talk to people, we're looking at these medium to understand. Which one would you pick?
Even this is a multiple choice.
This is
option.
Also
you
multiple.
Can choose
Thank
multiple
you very
items.
Much. Thank you very much, Adeshi. It is a multiple choice. You can choose more than one. Which one would you pick? And ask, keep asking yourself, why am I picking this? Why am I picking LinkedIn? Why am I picking in articles to write? Why am I picking in Facebook? Why am I picking Lions Club or a Rotary Club? Why am I picking a Twitter? So why am I picking any of these? So ask yourself that question. Yeah, can we stop it? Or you want to take a moment?
No, I've stopped it.
Yeah, we can stop it here.
These are okay. The results.
Yeah, 1 minute. Switched off and switched on. Yeah. In terms of, in terms of LinkedIn, we have chosen. Sorry, I'm just power has come back, so I'm also making my attempts to switch on the AC because. Switch it on. No. Put it away. That's all. Thank you. 37 of you chosen LinkedIn. Articles popping 57 on 88 have chosen, which is 65%, 42%. 34 on 88 have chosen Facebook, which is very good. I'm surprised and happily surprised that people have chosen to write articles or blog, which is very interesting. 34 on 88, which is 39%. Joining Rotary, very good. 29 on 88, which is 33%. Twitter, very good. I mean, I'm fascinated with people choosing Twitter. Somebody told me that the student community or the college community does not use Twitter as a mechanism. I think you guys are proving it wrong about this. In terms of ask yourself what makes you choose. These are five choices I picked up because I looked at some of the international preferences people use and I picked those to make a reference here. So why would you pick? So keep asking yourself that question. So why would you pick LinkedIn or article or blogging or joining a Rotary Club? So think, keep that. Now this focus, the second question was, if I want information, where would I go? Now here in terms of if I want to make myself visible, my identity visible. So which one would I choose? Yeah, could we close this, Adeshji? Done, okay. Now the last poll, I'm sorry. Okay, now the fourth question is, I want to connect with important people, well-known people. Whatever you define as important people or a well-known people. Now, well-known people could be respected people in the community, or it could be people I read about it in the news and I want to connect with them, or it could be highly respected people from the industry probably, or I would want to connect with people who are professionals in a particular line of business, or it could be some of the professors you want to connect with. Some of you are there. Want to be connected with. So which ones would you choose? Lovely. Thank you very much, friends. Thank you for it. The power has come back. My AC is beginning to work. So hopefully I will sweat lesser. I'll just take your permission to, while you're doing that, to ensure that AC is working or not. Let me check it out. Sorry. Lovely. Great. Wow. Yeah, I think, Adeshji, we can close this in a few seconds because, oh, wow, more people are responding. That's nice. I'm
Yeah, we'll close another 5 seconds.
Great. Great. Excellent.
So these are the results.
Lovely. Okay, lovely. I'll just make a note of it. We'll wait for college functions. 34 or 97, say that. Wow, 34 or 97, again, people say LinkedIn. People choose 28 or 97, 20 or 97, 58 or 97. Yeah, people who have chosen. See, yeah. when you join a well-known voluntary organization, or when you join a Rotary Club or Alliance Club, or when you wait for a college function, you physically go and talk to those people. You go and say, I've read your article, or I know I want to connect with you. I want to reach out with you. I want to be in touch with you. So there are a lot of ways we physically do that. Ponder over for a moment. How would you do that on LinkedIn? I mean, if you can share your thoughts, it will be great on the chat section. How would you ask these questions on Twitter, on LinkedIn? And also in terms of if there is a newer way that you will approach your approach would be a little different in terms of reaching out to well-known people in terms of industry or business or an academic profession. So please write your thoughts on that, because it will be very useful to understand. See, this session is not, is less about gyan and more about understanding ourselves and going and implementing it. So that's where you'll find that in the earlier sessions, you would have seen me give a lot of inputs about concepts right from the beginning. So here I'm actually making you think a lot, ponder over, reflect, look at it from what others are saying. Please, let me request you, there is no right answer. Oh, so they have written college function. I didn't choose. Oh, should I choose that? No. Each one has a perspective. I'm only requesting, be open to another person's perspective, especially when some of you are sharing your thoughts here. Look at it. Oh, yeah, maybe I should explore this. I never looked at college functions, an opportunity to connect with well-known people. Some of the leading luminaries come to my college as guests to my college. I sit in the back bench and I just listen to it. Wow, I've understood something and I go. I don't make an attempt to connect with them at all. So how do I connect with them? That's something you can ponder over it. Lovely. So shall we close this? Yeah, lovely. Okay. Now we looked at 4 polls. What are we going to cover in the next about 30 minutes? Yeah. We're looking at things. One, we covered 4 polls are over. There's only one more poll at the end of it, which we will relook at our thoughts. We will make an attempt to understand. When I use the word attempt to understand, each subject is very, very deep inside. So it is just an overview I can share with you. Beyond that, it is up to you to understand about it in your thoughts, in your action, in your writing, in your reading. And we will also look at what are the elements of personal branding, which is what we have called this session as personal branding 1.0. Okay, so what is visibility credibility matrix? We are talking about it. So we talked about, if you look at it previously, we said visibility credibility, we'll talk about it. You may want to note it down, what is this means, or you want to look at this graph and say, where am I here? Am I highly credible or I am not so credible? Am I highly visible or am I not highly visible? Now, if you remember, I asked you a question earlier. This is to connect it. If I want to make myself visible, which one would I choose? Now, I'll ask you a question for you to think about it. The question was, which one will you choose? Now, I'm asking, which one have you chosen now? Visibility, and to what extent have you got dividends for that? How much of return have you got? I'm not saying that change the forum. See how you can make yourself visible with extra effort in the same forum. For example, you said that, let's say you're writing articles, you're blogging, you have your own personal blog. No, maybe you think that I'm not yet visible. So start thinking about it. How do I make my articles visible? How do I make people aware that I am a writer? I can contribute on certain topics. I have certain views. Now, how would I do that? So think from that perspective. So when you talk about this visibility, so where am I in terms of visibility? Am I high or am I low? So visibility is not what others think of you. It is what you think of yourself, because others will give you opinions from saying that what you should do. But here you should say, how visible should I be? Should I be 100% visible or should I be 80% visible? See the graph, when you look at the visibility part of it, which is the y-axis. Now, where do I want to be in the visibility? I may not want to be visible totally. I'm happy with moderate visibility, or I'm okay with low visibility. I don't know. Think about it. Where do you view yourself in terms of visibility? Immediately you will say, if I'm not visible, I will not get promoted. I will not get a job. We'll worry about that later. The question of where do you want to be? Where are you and where do you want to be? We can just put a dot there. Where am I now? And where would I like to be in terms of visibility? See, always the growth is about where am I and where do I want to go? Not where am I and where others are. We are not comparing with others in these graphs. Where am I and where do I want to go? Now, again, in terms of the x-axis, look at the credibility. So, where am I in terms of credibility? Am I low in credibility or am I high in credibility? So just view that from your perspective. So am I highly credible? Am I being respected? My views are heard. People look forward to listening to my views. People come and ask me for my views. People want to be influenced by my thoughts. There are a lot of people seeking my inputs when I come to college as a professor or as a student. I am highly asked for any problem solving. They come and approach me. So think about it in terms of your credibility and visibility. So where am I and where do I want to go? So just pick this, which quadrant am I in now? Which quadrant do I want to go? Or if you're already in a particular quadrant and you want to retain there, maybe look at it, how much more would you want to increase in that? So this is visibility, credibility. This is an internationally acclaimed concept, which was propounded by Brendan Williams, about I think 30, 40 years back. So that's a visibility credibility concept. Now let's look at what is personal branding now. So we've talked about a lot and let's come to our core concept of what is personal branding. Personal branding is the conscious and intentional effort. There is an effort that I have to do to create and influence public perception. How people view me, how people perceive me as an individual and positioning them, okay? To create that and positioning my persona as an authority in that particular field. So it talks about branding is the conscious and intentional effort to create and influence public perception of an individual. In this case, it is me, by positioning them, that person which is me, as an authority in that particular field. So how do I do that? By elevating the credibility. And also, whilst I say that don't compare with yourself, there is always that there are people there. I am a student of arts. 60 other students of arts are there in my class, in across Chengalpet, Chennai. So everybody is there. So how do I differentiate myself? Please understand, differentiation is not by comparison. Differentiation is by being yourself. When they say differentiate yourself from competition, don't think about it. Okay, they are doing this. Now, let me do 1.1x. No. They are doing that. Great for them. I am doing this. Maybe I can borrow something from them. But I am not going to compare and make myself a clone. That's not the effort. Be unique, be different, stay where you are, start building your identity from there. Why am I doing all this stuff? All this personal branding that is being talked about it. I need to advance in my career. whoever you are, if you're a professor, lecturer, teacher, principal, I want to advance my career. What is advance my career? I have no clue on that. Remember, we did a goal setting exercise. You must look yourself. Where do you want to be 5 years later? Did you write that goal with a smart plan, specific, measurable, achievable, relevant, and time bound or realistic? Where do I want to be? From that perspective, now I will use this personal branding. I want to increase my circle of influence. I am influencing few people. Maybe I want to influence more people. That's my perspective. Or maybe I want to make a larger impact. It is not just only career part of it. I may also want to make a higher impact, a better impact, more impact, which is what? So this is broadly is personal branding. Now, why did we call personal branding? I'll just take a moment to explain, to connect with that. If you want to drink a cup of coffee, at home, of course, you will drink coffee. Let's say you want to go out and drink a cup of coffee. Just think for a moment. Will you go alone or will you pick a friend? If you pick a friend, which friend are you picking? Why are you picking that friend? First point. Second, you want to go out to a particular store, particular shop. Why that particular shop? This person, friend, and that shop has made an impact on you in some form or other. So that has built a brand in you that when I want to drink coffee, I'll go to this shop and I will go with this friend. Okay, I have to drink coffee and I want to go alone. Are you going to the same shop or are you going to a different shop? Why? Many times it may be the same shop. Why? Okay, I'm not going out for a cup of coffee. I'm going to have my cup of coffee at home only. Which coffee brand are you picking up? Is it Vivekananda coffee or a Leo coffee or an instant coffee like Nescafe or a Sunrise or whatever? Which one are you picking? Why? What made you pick that up? Many of us buy things from the shop just like that. Why are we picking those items? Just like you pick brands from the shop, people will also pick us up as a brand if we make our identity as a brand. You go to the shop, there are certain items not picked by people at all. Why? Why is it not picked by people? Maybe they have not made attempts to become visible. Maybe they have not made attempts to showcase their credibility. Think about it. Why? Why is that? So likewise, this is about personal branding. There are four elements of it. One is personal proof. You will be surprised to note at the end of the session, all this I know. Exactly all of it you know. I am just putting a structure and making you aware of it. Please believe me, personal branding 1.0, you know about it. Probably right from you were about 8 or 9 years, because you have been conscious of your identity since then. The type of dress you wear, the way you behave, the way you speak, the way you deal with it, the way you arrange, the way you showcase yourself, the way you study. You have been building, the way you teach to people if required, you have been building that identity. So just reflect on that. First one, personal proof. In about 15 minutes, I think we should complete it. So we'll take the questions thereafter. I think the momentum is going on. I don't want to miss that. Personal proof. All of it, you know. Build your resume. You must always have your resume current. Whether you are a professor, lecturer, teacher, student. Professor might say or a principal, "Naa enga vela vittu poporana, inga thana irukku." No, it is not for you to look for a job. Please understand, resumes are not meant for jobs. It's a misconception that only for jobs you need to have a resume. I am a trainer, I am a coach, I am pitching for a business, and I want to talk to somebody. What is the first thing they ask? Send me your profile. I'm not looking for a job in that company. First thing they ask, send me your profile, which is in their parlance, a brief outline. Resume can be in different forms, one from a job perspective, one from a profile perspective, or one from trying to showcase it when you make presentations for in your college or in some other college or some other college function. What do they do? They read out your profile. What is that? That's your resume. Do I have it with me now? It must be current. Look at it every month. Keep adding, keep changing, keep deleting. Because you can't have more than page or a two. You can't have 10 pages and keep adding it. Nobody's going to read a 10-page resume when you send it across. It must be a quick resume. If you're a professor or a lecturer, it's always good to have one or two pages. Don't go beyond 2 pages. If you're a college student, again, one would be very short. Keep it for 2 pages. Why I'm saying 2 pages is you'll know why it is 2 pages. Oh, but I don't have enough to write about it. No problem. Start with 1 page. Start somewhere. What do you learn other than in resume? I will talk about my academic qualifications, professional qualifications, certificates, courses I've attended. Anything that you attend, you attending this course, you get a certificate, you must write it in your resume. But why should I tell about it? Then why do you need a certificate? If you don't want a certificate, fine. I don't want to talk about it, it's fine. But if you want to talk about it, write it down. You must talk about your experience. You can always choose to, it's always preferable to write your experience in what you are currently doing. If you're a professor or lecturer or a principal, what you're currently doing and go down to the last. So start from descending order, start now and go to the your first job, whatever you did. Experience. Students will say, no, I don't have any experience. I'm sure you may have some experiences. You may have taught, you might have taken some internship, or you must have taken some summer placements, or you must have taken some summer jobs. You may not have taken it up as a job where you were given an employment certificate or a job. You must have just gone into a shop somewhere or a small store or a small company. You worked there for a month or two. Put it down. That's your experience. Achievements. Before that, I'll just take a sip of water. There are 4 elements. Personal proof is the most important one because that's the most neglected one. It's the most easiest one, most simplest one. So experience, we talked about it. Achievements. Achievements are what you consider are achievements. Achievements are not world perceives an achievement. I just did one small thing there and I know you did something different. You took a project, you completed a project, or you took up an assignment for the college, or you took up, you did something, write it down. You conducted a seminar, that's an achievement. You conducted a get together, it's an achievement. You presented a paper, it's an achievement. Write it down briefly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Skills, this is especially for students. Now, what skills do you have? Then somebody is reading your resume, they would like to know what skills do you have. Now, what are skills? Now, there is a problem solving skills, there is an analytical skill, there is a leadership skill, there is a communication skill, there is an interpersonal relationship skill. There is a motivation that you can, you know, learned about it. We discussed about it. There is motivation. You have certain skills. You may have teaching skills. You might have taught a few students. You have a teaching skill. So all that are skills. Whatever is a skill, this is especially for students who are aspiring to get into a corporate environment. When you write it down, you don't have to explain that, but write it down. If you want, write another line, but if you don't write it, it's okay. But these are the questions that they will ask when they look at its skills and you say you have an analytical skill. So they'll ask you, so what did you analyze? So you must be able to give an example of these skills when you go for the interview or for a discussion. That is when you need to be able to showcase it with example. You don't have to write the example here, but you must be able to connect it. You can't say there, sir, they told me to write some skills, I've written analytical skills, I don't know what it is. No, don't do that. Please write it, what each skill means. for professors, teachers, lecturers, principal, if you have a specific skill set, something distinct that you have, please feel comfortable to mention that. But it is required, it is not required. Let me explain to you why it is required. Sometimes you have a distinct skill which you want to showcase. If you think that you already have mentioned it in your experience or in the achievement, you don't have to mention the skill. People will be able to read it. But if you still think that you have an analytical skill, like for, I'm just giving an example. I have a big data analytical skill and I have analyzed some big data of a particular enterprise and I've analyzed it and I've presented it as a paper. Great. That's a skill you have. Social proof. First is the personal proof. Second is the social proof. All the four are some way connected. That's where I put emphasis on the personal proof. What is social proof? Social proof is the proof that other people need in order to believe that we are qualified to do something. Others need to believe. There are things that lead people to believe that you can help them. You have something that they may want. What you say in the personal proof must be validated outside. How do you do that? Now, some of you have mentioned that you have Facebook and you have Twitter and all that, you have blogs. How many people are following you? How many people are connected with you? How many people read about it? Blogger, you write, you publish it. How many people view? How many people comment on that? It's very important. Where all have you gone and spoken? If you had made presentations, where all have you spoken about it? In the public forum, LinkedIn or Facebook, you would have shared your experiences. Somebody would have acknowledged it. So those are all social proof of it. You would have said there, I can give you references or whatever. Now you will have proof that these are people have referred. These people are willing to, for example, international universities would ask for referrals. From whom? From the professors, they ask for referrals. So that's a social proof. So what is the personal proof? Second one is the social proof. Please understand that it is important to not just build your personal profile, but also tell other people that I am this. Which could be through Facebook, which could be through LinkedIn, which could be through Twitter, which could be through Instagram, which could be through blogging, which could be through your video presentation on YouTube. You can speak about it. And this Vidyasagar Women's College, which is conducting this session on it's the fourth one that we're doing it. It's available on YouTube. You want to speak something and showcases, put it on YouTube. 3-minute video, 5-minute video. That's an evidence of your communication skills, your presentation skills, your knowledge. You can do that. You have your mobile, just record it, put it. That's a social proof. Association, whom you know, whom are you connected with that? Remember, we asked a question earlier. If I want to connect with well-known people, how would I do that? Do I wait for college functions, LinkedIn, joint Rotary, Twitter, or volunteering? Whom do you know? And does the world know that you know these people? There are two aspects of it. I know well-known people, that others know that I know these well-known people. That's a very interesting perspective. I know these well-known people. All these well-known people are not going to give me jobs. All these well-known people are not going to give me presentation engagements. But people who see that you are connected with these people know, oh, great. Yeah, she knows these people. Great. It's something people, why do they go and pick videos or selfies with film stars? Why do they do? That is association. So I can have an association. I can do a selfie with Dhanush or with Vijay or actor Rajinikanth. Now, if I just keep it with me at home, that is association. But I put it in Facebook, that becomes a social proof. Are you able to see the point? Association, what type of people you have worked with? What companies have you worked with? What type of friends are you associated with in Facebook? Are you just associated with only your classmates? Or are you associated only with your schoolmates? Or are you going expanding little further schoolmates, college mates, with professors, with my neighbors, with my friends. So what are your friends and connections there? Are you following somebody in Twitter? Are you messaging on Twitter? Has anybody written about you, or have you written about somebody else? What about your family and friends? I mean, somebody well-known could be there in your family or friend circle, which you are associated with. You're studying in this college, whichever college you're coming from, you're studying in that college. How many of them know about that particular college in your Facebook or your LinkedIn or your Twitter? If you are a professor or a lecturer, teacher, you must be a part of an alumni. Are you visible there? Are you going there? Are you reaching out there? Yeah, what type of clubs? You talked about Lions in Rotary, I just brought it as an example. So are you associated with that? There is a Madras Management Association, there is a CII, there is a FICCI. There are different types of organizations that are available, associations that are there. So where am I associated with? So this is about, so we looked at personal proof, social proof, association. Fourth one is recognition. Have I been recognized? Professor of the month, lecturer of the month, student of the month. If you are a student, are you in the top percentile of the class? Or if you are a professor, what is the performance of your students vis-a-vis other students in the college, in the community, in the neighborhood? So where are they? So that's where you get your recognition. You may get academic awards, you may get speaking awards, you may have local community awards. Anything that gives you visibility. People might, like, for example, each locality has this business paper, newspaper that is coming in. Now, unfortunately, because of these, maybe most of the local newspapers don't publish. So people put in awards, some club there. Please, it may be a small community there. They've given you recognition. Please put it there. You got recognition. That's a social proof. Now display it somewhere. Make people aware. So personal proof, social proof, association, recognition. There are a lot more. That's why I've said this is a personal branding 1.0. This is the starting part of it. Get this right. Oh, you can go places. Will I definitely go places? Try it out. Just make these attempts and you will start seeing changes both in you and the way you look at the world and the way the world starts looking at you. That's the most important. You have to start looking at yourself differently, which makes you look at the world differently, which eventually makes the world look at you differently. We looked at four elements. So personal proof, social proof, association. Wonderful. I'm going to give you a small work to do. Not now. Go back, relax, sit down. But do it. Do it. What is the exercise? Write about, this is not resume. Write about yourself. You remember when we go there in some TV interviews, when the personality is not very well known, they ask him, sir, ungala pathi konja solla mudiyuma? So he'll speak about few words about himself or herself. Or the person will introduce you. So one page, two page, three page, write any number of pages. Write about yourself first. Then what do I do? Read. Keep reading. When you read about it, you'll say, oh, this has not come out well. Oh, that has come out very well. Okay, you work around, you put point, you structure, you restructure, you redo. Oh, please believe me, this is not the end of it. You'll have to keep writing it. When you look at it 3 months later, maybe you would have written the 175th version. That's okay. It keeps evolving. The more you keep writing about yourself, what will happen? You start building your identity and you start building your brand. Okay, great. Now let's do a poll and then come back to discussing questions. Adeshji, the same question that I asked in the poll number one is the poll here. Now tell me, what is your thought about personal branding? Is it style? Is it substance? Is it nothing? Or is it both? Now, can we have your views, please? Adeshji?
Yeah, I have launched.
Lovely. Thank you very much. I see that 40 people have joined in later to the poll that we started.
Yes.
So I know that we will be biased
yes.
with it, but that's okay. That's okay. Lovely, 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 lovely. Oh, some of you still feel it's neither. Okay, I would like to see your views. What makes you say that? Maybe put in your chat. I will read it later. There's only one you can choose. So, you want to give them 10 more seconds?
Yeah, I think we'll.
Great. Wow. 100. Responded. I would like to read it. Adeji, can you forward those comments later to me as you
I will
normally
do, that.
Do?
I will do that. I'll
so
do that.
I would like to read it at leisure. I'll do it after
I'm
this.
I'm ending the poll now.
Lovely. So we have 18 per people, 18 people, 9 people, 72 people, 62%, 8, 15, 15. Now let's compare the percentage part of it. I'm not looking at the numbers. Okay, 73 people had participated in the poll number one. Here it is. How many of them have participated in this poll? 72, 81.
This is about 113.
Am I right? 36, 36, 45, 45 would be 127.
Yeah, correct.
117. Yeah, 117. Okay, great. So from 73, we have 117 people. Now, wow, 47% said both. Now 62% have said both. Now 30% had still style. Now only 15% are saying style. Now 15% said substance, 15% are still saying substance. Wow. Okay. 8% said neither, 8% are still saying neither. Okay. Great. Now, I'll tell you why I asked this question here, and I'll just take a moment and we'll take the questions. People who say only style is important, okay, ask yourself, am I being focused on visibility without showcasing the credibility? Is it only me or is it also my credibility coming out? For the people who said substance only is important, I'm not going to debate on that. Each one of you are entitled, and yes, it's the perspective to look at it. When I look at substance, which is the credibility part of it, do I want to make little more people outside my circle aware of it? You don't have to go and tom-tom. People say, I don't like to blow my trumpet. Don't have to blow your trumpet. Are you available on LinkedIn? Are you available on Twitter? Are you available on Facebook? You don't have to do anything. Post your articles there. Post your thoughts there. You have become, people will come in search of you. That's the beauty of these concepts in social media today. Lovely. Okay. So let's take the questions now. Where are we? Just to summarize, we looked at the polls. We looked at the visibility, credibility matrix. We looked at where are you in terms of visibility, low and high, credibility and visibility, where am I? We looked at the four elements of personal branding, which is personal proof, social proof, my association, and my recognition. Okay, so let's take questions now.
Okay, friend, so now shall I read the questions out to you? Shall
okay,
I read?
So or? I'm not. Yeah, fine.
Yeah,
you're the boss.
Right. No boss here. It's just the four questions. I think many more will come in as we progress.
Okay. Let's keep first, in mind that I made a commitment that we will stop at about 75 minutes, 5:15. So let's keep
yeah,
the
yeah.
time.
Yeah, I'm aware of it. I'm aware of it. Okay. So can you just close the screen share now?
Yeah, I will do that. One minute. Lovely. Okay.
Beautiful. One second. Just a little bit. Yeah, I think. Okay, the question from Sneha. Can we please explain about the poll 1 and 2 once again?
Okay, poll 1 and 2, that's what is style means? Style means that, see, I wanted to use another word for visibility, credibility. So I chose this. Style means focus on Tanakumanakku. The way I dress, the way I showcase myself, the way I make myself visible. So that's the style part. Substance is what is the content that I have with me, which is the credibility part of it. I can give a lovely speech without anything people understanding. So I'm visible. Am I credible? I may have a lot of information. I may be the most intelligent man probably on this subject that people know about it in my circle. But beyond that, nobody knows about me. That's the substance part of it. Yeah. That's poll number one. Poll number two. Okay. See, the question was, if I want news, where will I choose? It is to for you to think which one is visible for you. If you think only newspaper is visible, Facebook also gives you news. Twitter also gives you news. How you pick the news is up to you. News does not mean that somebody has to say, Indriya Seidigal. No, news can also be that people giving their inputs is also news. News does not mean only news published by ANI, UPI, PTI, Doordarshan. Now, news is available in different... What is happening in the community? Somebody posts it. That's a news. Yeah?
Beautiful.
Lovely. So, let's take the next. What is the most important to... Okay. Divya Bharati has asked a question. What's most important to remember while personal branding? Simple answer. I'll not give you difficult answers. Yourself. You have to remember about yourself. Okay. Personal proof, social proof, association, recognition are all supporting factors. How can I improve my social proof, Sapana Shanmugam? How can I improve my social proof? How do you want to improve your social proof? How do you want to improve that? That's more important. How can I improve? I can give you a lot of ways, but how do you want to improve? That's the most important part of it. Now, what does social proof that we talked about it? Are you visible in the social media? Are you visible in writing? See, please, blogging does not mean that I have to have a website to blog. I can blog. I can write articles on LinkedIn. I can write articles on Facebook. I can write short articles, posts in Twitter also. I can post articles on Instagram. That's up to you. You have to make yourself visible. Okay. How can I make anonymous attendee? Okay, fine. I respect your...
Read the question.
How can I make my personal brand stand out if I'm not already super successful and well known? First of all, don't make yourself anonymous.
I was about to tell that.
Because your brand is all starts with your name. So Shakespeare said, somebody said, what's in a name? Anything which is called by any other name, the rose will smell like a rose. All that is fine, but it starts with your name. Always people connect with your name. Starts there. How do you want to stand out? Start identifying yourself by name to people. Now, don't hide behind. No. Ask this question. You don't ask your neighbor to ask the questions to the class teacher. Or if you're a professor or lecturer, don't ask your colleague to go and ask the principal. Stand out and ask. Nothing in the world will be lost. All right. Next.
Okay.
Sai Sanjana. Are there other forms other than social media as certain sections are still... Absolutely. I totally agree with you. I am totally in agreement with you. Please continue to print your resume. Please type it out in the Word document. Please do that. Email. I didn't mention email if you notice. Email is getting outdated. But I am only saying, whilst you do the email part of it, whilst you print it out part of it, please don't forget the social medium. That's all I'm trying to tell you. Yes, when I meet somebody, somebody will say, like for example, when I go for any speaking engagement, somebody will say, "Ninga print panni kodundringla na vandu mobile la padikiradhu enak kashtam." So I can't tell him, "No, I am not in this. I have printed out and give it to him. I put it in nice." So when you put it, please put a, make it A4, put borders. Don't put jigna jigna. Put a nice A4, buy a A4 plastic folder, which is available for 7, 8, 9 rupees. Nice one. Put it there. Clean one. Give it. Visibility. What do you think is more effective in 2020? I have no clue. It's nothing with 2020. Every day it keeps changing. Today we talk about personal branding with this. 1 year later, maybe we will talk with something else. Can I, Shiva Shankari, can I improve or enhance core competency instead of focusing more on visibility? Famous personality, for example, MS Dhoni. How did you know MS Dhoni, first of all? He became so visible. That's why you know about him. Otherwise, why are you talking about MS Dhoni? He makes himself so visible by being ensuring he's not visible is one part of his style. He ensures that he doesn't make himself visible. He has got a whole army of people working on his visibility. Okay. First of all, I'll take Amazon's example. Way back when he came in about 20, he's about 37, 38, about 12, 13 years back, 24 when he came in. If you know his visibility, he had long hair. Parvez Musharraf had told him in India-Pakistan match, when he won the man of the match, Parvez Musharraf then was the president of Pakistan, had told him, please don't cut your hair. It is visible. That's your distinct stamp. What is all that? That's visibility. Okay. You can't build credibility without visibility. You can build credibility only with few people knowing about it, or you have other people to build that. But at this point of time, it is costlier. So it's better to build ourselves. Today, you look at LinkedIn or Twitter. I'll give you a simple example. I don't want to go beyond that. We're at 5-2. There is a gentleman called Anand Mahindra. He's the chairman he's only the chairman of Mahindra Group. He tweets personally, he types. Harsh Goenka, chairman of SIAT Tires, he tweets. Visibility is required for them. All your credibility is required to showcase it. Yeah. Vachala says, what are powerful personal branding? Whatever I understand in that, it is, end of the day, branding is all about me. I didn't understand the question, so maybe if I understand it.
Okay. Now, have you answered? Okay. Done. Okay. How can one increase the skill?
Yeah, I think that's a different subject by itself, which is not part of personal branding. So I don't want to get into that, because skill is something that you have to work on and identify which skill. Now, is it communication or is it public speaking? Is it presentation? Is it interpersonal? Is it analytical? Is it problem solving? Is it team working? Is it whatever? You have to identify which one and talk to your friends, talk to your professors. Talk to trainers like us and ask for inputs. Reading alone will not help. You have to practice a lot.
Okay.
Is there any other way? I told you about it. We talked about it. If there is a college function, if there is a Rotary Club, voluntary organization. Oh, there are hundreds of ways to do that. There are hundreds of ways. Is social media very much important for personal branding? See, it's a question like now saying that, should I use WhatsApp when I still have the landline phone connection available? I will not use WhatsApp. I will use only telephones to speak. Yeah, you can speak on the phone, but somebody has to have a landline there to receive the call. So Facebook is used by 2.5 billion people. So why would I want to leave that? And Narmada, why would I want to leave that and be somewhere else? See, social medium, whether it's WhatsApp, Telegram, or Hike, or any of these messengers, or this brand social other medium like Twitter, Facebook, these are all medium. You have to use it for your benefit. What is your personal brand strategy? I'll share with you. I'll share something I've learned. Okay, let me admit it. I've been in various businesses, and let me admit it openly here. I have no shame in that. Although it was a very shameful experience I underwent, now I don't feel it because that's why I'm able to speak about it. I was in banking, I was in insurance, I was in private aviation, I was in financial consulting. So what happened was I built people in different corners, and I realized that I have not integrated them. So then I realized that let me go back to two things when I'm very comfortable. One of them is training. So I've come back to training in the last about 1.5-2 years. So I'm rebuilding my personal brand as a trainer. You can visit my LinkedIn profile, PK Raghunathan, which is visible. You can connect with me, Purnamati. So I am now building my brand as a trainer coach. That's my personal brand. Okay. Just by creating a profile in social media, how will one become a brand? Kirtana, just by writing your resume, people will not know about it. I have written my resume. Yeah, you can keep the resume at home. You must build on it. Social media is everyday activity, not every minute activity, at least everyday activity. You create your profile, you start writing, you start connecting, you start writing in other people's posts. You very polite. Don't get into attacking and debating. Avoid that. You start with that resume, you have to build, you have to tell people, tell them I can do, keep changing your profile, keep working on your resume, keep changing your resume. Okay. What do you think is the safest way? Sai Sanjana, second question you're asking. What do you think is the safest way to do personal for women? Okay, I think that's a very, very, very powerful question. See, your picture is important. How you put your picture is also important. I appreciate that question. I'm very sensitive to such requirements. I appreciate the question you asked. I think you are asked a question for many other women listening to this discussion. If you're uncomfortable sharing personal details, don't share. You don't want to talk about your father, mother, brother, sister, date of birth. Don't talk about it. Get into that forum. Start connecting with your close friends. Just like social media is like staying at home. How you stay at home is how you stay in that. If you deal with the neighboring community in family around, I mean, outside house, how you behave is how you behave there. Here I behave like this. It will reflect there. Here, if I behave carefully, I will also behave carefully there. I really appreciate the thought and the question that you asked. Safest way is that what you do at home nearby is what you do there also. Thank you.
Beautiful.
Pavitra, if you are resistant, then how can we get out from it for getting? I didn't understand. I'm assuming that if I'm uncomfortable, should I get out? I don't know. I mean, I'm not able to understand this question.
We'll skip the question.
Personal branding is about style or substance. Dr. Mahalakshmi, it's both. If you're visible, but people don't know for what you are known for, build your credibility. I'm credible, but people don't know me. Start building your visibility. What are personal branding secrets? Bachala, please, I think you can read a lot about it. And when you Google or Bing, Bling or Bing or Yahoo or whatever, you will get a lot of secrets. I mean, my endeavor is not to give you any tips about what other people do. My endeavor is to build your brand. That's when I said, write about you, who you are. Build your identity first. Build your brand. Should personal branding be considered as a primary or a secondary thing in one's life? Yogalakshmi, the choice is yours. There is nothing called a primary or a secondary. Just like you prepare a resume and just like you go out and talk to friends in the neighborhood and you talk to family over the phone or your friends over the phone, like that is the social medium.
Okay, so we have so, another 5 minutes.
Yeah.
And 8 questions to answer.
You don't become a brand by creating a profile, Kirtana. You are a brand. People should know about you. That's all is the perspective. I can't have rinse soap made and I don't advertise about it or I don't talk about it or I don't make it visible. Yeah? You are a brand. You have to make it visible. What steps should I start to take in? I thought, Jayashree, we spent talking about personal proof, social proof, recognition and association. Yeah, these are starting points. First, build your resume first to start with and start connecting with people in whatever form you want to.
Kirtana has typed her question again and again, so I'm just dismissing that.
No, maybe there's a reason. Just go back and read that. Maybe she wants to. Maybe I didn't answer a question or something. What is that question?
Just by creating a profile in social media, how will one become a brand? Same question.
Yeah, as I said, not by creating a profile, you become a brand. You're already a brand. How do I make the brand visible to people? That's all.
Is personal branding possible without social media?
Divya Bharati, it is possible. I mean, not everybody is in Twitter today. Let me tell you that. Sonia Gandhi is not in Twitter. Let me tell you that. I don't know whether actor Ajit is in Twitter. So, you can.
Okay, this is an interesting question. How to find my area of branding?
Kirtana, how to find your area of branding? That's where your story writing will tell you. The more you write about it, you will know that what is your identity all about in terms of what you want to showcase. Like, for example, we talked about, somebody asked for my profile. So my endeavor is to talk about my training ability and coaching ability. That's what I'm talking about it. So you will start writing it, you will discover it. Yamalata asks, 2 examples of substance credibility. What does credibility mean? Your work experience is a credibility, your skills are a credibility, your achievements are a credibility, your articles are a credibility, your knowledge is a credibility, your experience is your qualifications is a credibility. Yeah.
Okay. So in resume writing, while writing all the papers published, it will not go for more sheets. Is that not an issue.
Niveta, that's a good point. What you can do is that there are a lot of papers, which is great. Means that amazing. You're doing a lot of papers. Excellent. That is what you're doing. So what I suggest you do is that you can write a brief note on what topics have you written articles on, rather than putting it and say that a list of articles will be provided on request. So let people know if you're putting it on social medium. LinkedIn has a provision to, I mean, you can mention a list of it, one or two, or you can make a reference in the summary where you have written articles on these topics. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or you can say I've written 27 articles, 42 articles, 42 papers. Or you can just put an annexure. It's okay. People, you can write, I've written 42 articles in your resume and the list of articles is attached here with. So he wants to read it, she wants to read it, it's their problem. You can give a list, but don't put the list as part of the resume, give it as an annexure.
Won't the idea of personal branding be misunderstood occasionally?
Are you being misunderstood today, Narmada? If you're misunderstood, if you're not misunderstood today, you will not be misunderstood as a brand also. Personal brand is about you. Salkapuram Sunita says, in my opinion, substance is more important than style. Am I correct or wrong? You are not correct. You are not wrong. substance is important because you have to start with substance. Without substance, you cannot showcase your style. So substance is important. Start with that. Yes.
What are the proportion should style?
I'm not getting into this about 1:2, 1:3. You start writing your identity. Start writing that. There's no formula for it. Please, let's not convert everything into a formula.
Okay.
What is meant by substance? We discussed it.
Okay, so done. We have.
I think next one also we discussed it. You start with substance and then you showcase that. That's natural. Without substance, what will you showcase? Can you explain poll 4 once again? If I want to connect with well-known people, what will I do? I'll wait for college functions. I post in LinkedIn or join Rotary, or I connect in LinkedIn or connect in Twitter or join a voluntary organization. See, basically, I've just given a 5 items. If I want to connect with well-known people, where would I go? Industry, community, neighborhood. I want to connect with people. So where would I go? Yeah.
Okay. So this is a very interesting question. Should my
Vatika
product
be necessarily unique to be promoted? Please start believing that it is unique. It is not necessarily unique. It is unique.
One last question popped up. We'll take this and
how about self-discipline and branding? Do you have, as much as you have self-discipline in your personal lives, branding is a reflection of who I am. Branding is not different from what I am. Okay. Can you please create a brand sign? Yeah, please create. But it should be in addition to your name and your photograph. It cannot be replacing your name or photograph. I'm not going to create. Please, you want to create, you can create Chandamil Raja. Wonderful friends, it was a pleasure talking to you. And some of the questions made me think. And I'm very happy one of them asked about sensitivity, about women. I'm grateful people ask such questions. Thank you very much for the opportunity given by Vidyasagar Women's College. I thank the principal. I thank Mr. Adesh and the management for this opportunity. Have a lovely evening. Please go back and write about yourself. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I mean, just before you leave, there were a lot of feedbacks. I will share the chat comment with you.
Please.
A lot of feedbacks. And one thing which stood out was that people said, we know what personal branding is, but the way you took the session, I couldn't resist, and that got reflected in some comments by some participants. So I will send you the chat link. You just have a look at it. It was a wonderful,
lovely,
wonderful session. And the beauty is you're connecting it with all your 3 sessions which you have done earlier.
Absolutely.
So someone who has just popped into this session alone, I think he gets a perspective of what has happened so far and how we are going about it. So there are a lot of people who have seen the prior 3 sessions and come for the 4th. So that's why the audience is growing on a daily basis. And
thank you very much.
And I mean, it was, I mean, I can't even imagine the kind of effort you're preparing in creating such wonderful and unique content. Thank you very much doing this for us. And I hope all the participants are able to benefit out of this. So thank you very much. We'll be back again next Thursday sharp at 4:00 with yet another session. Before I leave, a small, request for all the participants. Many are complaining that we are not able to join, which I am not able to understand. Why is it so? See, as soon as you register for the event, you get a confirmation mail. In the confirmation mail, there is a join section. You have to go and hit the join section. I think that's how you people are here. About 180, 190 are here. And there are about 40, 50 on YouTube. So you need to join with that. So if in case you interact with your colleagues who have not been able to join, can you just suggest them to check that mail? I sent this mail one day prior. I sent this mail 1 hour before the session. So that in case it gets lost in the number of mails you receive, you can go and check the mail which is received yesterday. or 1 hour before the session. So thank you very much for such wonderful questions, and thank you for your interaction and feedback on the chat. One more request for people who have not seen, or I saw a comment in the chat box, one of the professors saying that I had asked my students to register, but they were not able to join because the capacity was full. I suggest, if you think the session is useful or if you think the prior sessions are useful, I just got an idea as the question was posted. I will put in a small 5 questions or a feedback form in my YouTube link under each of these videos. What you can do is you can ask your students to go and see the video, answer the feedback question, and we'll make sure that all the students who answer and score above a particular mark, I will talk to the principal and devise a mechanism. We will provide certificates for them also. So if you think the sessions are useful for the students, please talk to your, inform your students. It's very simple, youtube.com/c/Vidyasagar Women's College. That's our website. In that, there is this Prayas, playlist. This is the 4th video in the list. They can go to any video. They can click on the link, see the video, answer the questions, and get a certificate. Thank you very much. See you again on the next Thursday, 4 p.m. sharp. Thank you. Have a good day.